It's always good to see each and every one of you today. And choirs sound good, aren't they? They sound good today. Singing us happy with the help of the Lord. Announcements are listed within the bulletin. Please take the opportunity to go through all those things to keep up with what's going on. And information is very good and powerful. So please read through these things so you have no excuse to say, "Well, preacher, I didn't know about it." And I will hopefully be able to point you to the bulletin. If it's not in the bulletin, then I will apologize. But so many things going on. So please take time to read through those. I do continue to stress prayer on Mondays from 5:30 to 6. And there's 3 points there, areas of focus that I've asked you as you go on your day to think about so that we can ensure that we are asking God for the right things so that we can continue to be a blessing to other people. Also, homecoming is coming up. That's August 27th. I've already put Miss Kathleen on supper duty. Amen. All right. You need to add to that, Kathleen? You're ready to go. If you'd like to help by bringing a dish in any way, please get with Miss Kathleen and invite all your friends. Reverend Beth Tipton, she will be preaching. And she's already got a message prepared. I saw her yesterday and she said, "I already have a message." And I said, "Okay, tell me the message now." No, I'm going to make you wait. So that excites me, right? God is working ahead of us, and I'm already expecting a very, very good and powerful service. So please mark your calendar for that day and tell your friends about it. Also, I believe we will be having a spaghetti dinner, right? Amy, can you tell us about that? Let's get a mic to you.
Next Sunday after the service, we will have a spaghetti supper fundraiser. In this night's meeting, the women will be discussing the service. For the church choir,
Are there any other announcements in the house this morning that need to be mentioned?
I know I've told a lot of you that I'm getting ready to have surgery. My pre-op is Tuesday and 8th. My operation is on the 15th. I'm having a lot of stress and worry over this, so each just please pray for me and pray for my anxiety because it is going strong right now over this.
About 2 weeks ago, I was at work, but I had on my head a problem. So I burned down. I got a people on the floor at the time. Yesterday, I'm asking if anybody can help me. They can start some mountain running through and close from the daughter. Anything that the doctor can help, deal with me and my wife. About that. And how about you get with? I didn't catch everything, but it was Dennis, and could you pass that or send me, and we'll get more information about that. But we're both going to be in prayer because of that situation.
Some of y'all may have heard, Ted's grandmother, still in the circle, passed away yesterday, and so they're going to be having her this time on Tuesday evening down at Dillon's, and Wednesday is the service at 11. So just put that family in your prayers. a few weeks ago, I mentioned my brother-in-law, Ron Phillips, that has liver cancer. He's been taking radioactive infusions to kill the two blood vessels going to the tumor. And he had one last Friday, and it's having severe reactions to it. Freezing, trembling, his whole body. Anyway, please keep him and my sister Paulette in your prayers.
You guys remember one of my wife's guys, the lady that plays with us, Jenny. She had surgery for thyroid cancer this past June, I guess it was. And she's at band camp. And she's out doing every one of the kids. She's 52 years old. I couldn't get her out of my office because she kept coming in going, "I feel so great. I just got all this energy," and so, yeah, so thank you for a prayer for Jimmy.
It's on Tuesday. We're going to have a birthday party for our cousin, Kathleen Gillespie, for her 94th birthday, so if you're in time, please come to Kirkland's at 12:30 for lunch.
Can you give us the time of day again?
12:30 at Kirkland on Tuesday, the 8th.
Okay. Any other announcements you have? Hey
there, Don. Just a reminder, I know it's in the bulletin, the Women of Trinity today at 5. We had such a good time. There are no expectations that you come and be blessed. Women of the same heart. So, and just if you signed up to something for the bereavement kit, I've got that list if you've forgotten what you might need to bring. So please come and join us at 5 and expect to be blessed and well.
Amen. You call that board.
Call Jennifer Lesna and Kathleen. This is the last week of Fell Walks of Time. So if you've not seen it, you can miss out. It's one of the best seasons that I can remember in a long time. So tell me this.
I was feeling like Rob Moore would. Oh, okay.
Back in my little box back here. I just wanted to quickly update folks on the morning, Saturday morning neighborhood prayer walks. Yesterday was the fourth morning that we've done it, and we have covered, we started here at the church and just sort of radiated out, mostly up and down Wyandotte Avenue and a few of the side streets, and we've covered 65 houses with prayer and two churches that are right here in our facility. So I feel that it's going strong. We've had low attendance, but that's okay. It doesn't matter. Two or more are gathered. That's all it takes. So in the last two Saturdays, we have had a few little visitors in the form of deer that has been wandering the neighborhood. We had one over here, and Amy and I came back, and there was one over here in the house next door to Kathleen. And then last Saturday, Tim and I were walking down Wyandotte, and that lot where that house burned down, there was a mama and two babies just standing there munching on the grass that's left over on that lot. So, it's really powerful to see and to be immersed like that with God's world and kingdom while you're also walking around and praying for your neighbors.
Thank you so much.